Welcome to our video on the medications that can increase neuropathy. Neuropathy comes in many forms, and it affects millions of people, and not just diabetics. Still, diabetic neuropathy is a major concern for type 2 diabetics, and you may already be experiencing neuropathic symptoms. But did you know that certain drugs, even some used to treat neuropathy, may cause adverse reactions and end up worsening your neuropathic pain? So it's very important that you understand the medications that can increase neuropathy. First off, if you haven't yet experienced neuropathic pain, you are probably wondering, what is neuropathy exactly? Typically, when doctors talk about this condition, they are referencing peripheral neuropathy, where nerves become damaged or diseased. That can lead to feelings of numbness, tingling, or even pain, especially in hands and feet. And because chronic high blood sugar can cause lasting damage to nerves, this condition has been reported to affect as much as 50% of diabetics worldwide. Unfortunately, while peripheral diabetic neuropathy can be treated through diet and medications, it is rare for it to be cured completely. And even more unfortunately, several types of drugs, especially some that are often prescribed to diabetics, have been found to create side effects that can heighten your risk of developing neuropathy or potentially increase neuropathic symptoms. So we should explain which pharmaceuticals have been flagged for this risk. But first, a disclaimer. If your doctor prescribes you a medication, then you should take it, plain and simple. All of these drugs have been FDA approved and should work to aid your health. Still, most any medication can come with serious side effects. And in general, many medications can become less potent to your body over time, meaning that your doctor may need to continually up your dosage. In turn, that can come with further side effects. So, before taking any new medication, be sure to consult your doctor about the specific pros and cons of taking that drug, especially over a sustained period of time. Okay, it's time to discuss which specific drugs to be aware of for their potential to raise your risk of neuropathic issues. One of the world's most prescribed medications, especially for older diabetics, may be a danger to your nerves. So, before you take it, ask your doctor about the risks for statins. There has been an ongoing debate as to whether or not statin medications can lead to nerve damage, as some studies have shown that this drug may actually supply neuroprotective effects. However, statin medications, which are commonly prescribed to treat high cholesterol levels, have been associated with a small but potentially significant increased risk of peripheral neuropathy when taken over extended periods. In fact, a recent review published in the journal Diabetes and Metabolic Syndrome, Clinical Research and Reviews, indicated that among over 700 type 2 diabetic participants, peripheral neuropathy was higher among those using statins than participants not taking statins. And several case reports have shown peripheral neuropathy development among patients on long-term statin therapy, with symptoms often being partially or fully reversible after halting their statin intake. Still, this is a clearly beneficial cholesterol-lowering treatment for millions of type 2 diabetics, and because there is conflicted evidence as to how statins affect nerve health, you should heed your doctor's advice if you are prescribed this medication. What medication used to treat chronic alcoholism may carry negative consequences for your nerves? That's just ahead. First, a class of commonly prescribed pharmaceuticals to be mindful of are fluoroquinolones. This spectrum of antibiotics, including ciprofloxacin and levofloxacin, are widely prescribed as a therapy for bacterial conditions like respiratory and urinary tract infections. So yes, they can be very beneficial and in many cases extremely necessary. However, a 2018 systemic review by the European Medical Agency showed that there is a risk of rare but long-lasting and potentially irreversible adverse reactions that could affect multiple body systems, including damage to the nervous system. And multiple studies revealed a significant association between fluoroquinolone use and the development of peripheral neuropathy. Separate data suggests that these antibacterial medications can create other neurological side effects, including severe nerve damage. In fact, due to their risk of causing peripheral neuropathy and serious nerve damage, the FDA has required warnings on fluoroquinolone labels since 2004, and they further updated and strengthened this warning in 2013. We hope you're finding this video helpful. Please give us a thumbs up by clicking the like button, and let us know your thoughts on pharmaceuticals. Have you had any serious side effects from anti-diabetes medications? Comment below to let us know. What medication, used to treat gout, can be detrimental for your nerves? That's coming up next. Now, let's take a look at a beneficial anti-alcoholism medication that may carry adverse effects for your nerve health. Disulfiram. This common medication used to treat alcoholism can naturally be life-saving. However, it is also important to understand that it has a well-documented potential side effect, and that is peripheral neuropathy. Research suggests that disulfiram may affect Schwann cells, a type of cell surrounding neurons, as well as myelin, or the protective coating layer surrounding nerves. While the exact mechanism of neurotoxicity for this medication is not yet fully understood, disulfiram-induced sensory motor neuropathy has been observed in multiple case reports. However, most of these cases showed complete recovery from neuropathic symptoms upon discontinuation of taking disulfiram, usually within a few months. And according to a 17-year study published in the journal Alcohol and Alcoholism, disulfiram-linked neuropathy appears to be dose-dependent, with higher doses and prolonged use increasing the risk of severe neuropathy, while lower doses tend to be associated with milder neuropathic symptoms. Stay tuned to the end of this video to learn which drugs specifically prescribed to treat neuropathy may unintentionally cause more neuropathic symptoms. Now, if you are suffering from gout or inflammatory pain in your joints, you may be prescribed colchicine. This anti-inflammatory medication can help prevent or treat attacks of gout. However, a major side effect of this drug is its ability to create neuromuscular toxicity, including neuropathy. Studies show that the risk of this toxicity is heightened in those who have impaired renal function. However, if you have normal renal function, colchicine may still create neuropathic symptoms for you. Other studies have found that this drug can also lead to myopathy, or muscle disease affecting muscle fibers. Symptoms of myopathy include muscle weakness, stiffness, cramps, and spasms. Luckily, the Journal of Clinical Rheumatology noted that these symptoms should go away once you stop taking this medication. Coming up, we'll reveal the specific medications that are intended to lessen symptoms of neuropathy, and we'll explain why they may also create possibilities for increased neuropathic pain. Next, if you suffer from tachycardia or other types of heartbeat issues, this helpful medication may still create neuropathy. We're talking about amiodarone. Many people can develop heart arrhythmias, including tachycardia, where your heart rate is faster than normal. And there are many anti-arrhythmic medications on the market, including amiodarone. However, research indicates that a main side effect of this drug is its potential to induce peripheral neuropathy. Indeed, studies show that amiodarone may harm Schwann cells, thereby leading to demyelination, or damage to the myelin sheathing around nerves. In turn, this impairs nerve conduction, thus resulting in peripheral neuropathy. In fact, several case reports have observed peripheral neuropathy symptoms for patients utilizing long-term, high-dose amiodarone therapy. Side effects of this medication are also associated with optic neuropathy, or damage to nerves in eyes, which can lead to vision loss. There have even been other serious side effects reported for this drug, including neuropathic foot deformity, which weakens bones in the foot to the point of fracture. Now it's time to explore some specific anti-neuropathy drugs that may end up worsening your neuropathy. These include aldose reductase inhibitors, anti-epileptic meds, tricyclic antidepressants, and opioids. Unfortunately, many commonly prescribed and extremely beneficial medications for treating neuropathic pain can create the opposite effect. Aldose reductase inhibitors, including sorbinil and apalrostat, are meant to manage or reduce secondary diabetes complications, including symptoms of diabetic neuropathy. However, if not properly dosed, this type of medication can create the side effect of exacerbating these issues. Of course, anti-epileptic medications like carbamazepine, gabapentin, and pregabalin are important for many people, and they are commonly prescribed in the treatment of neuropathic pain. However, studies also show that they too can lead to heightened neuropathic symptoms if not properly monitored by your doctor. Tricyclic antidepressants like amitriptyline and nortriptyline are also often used for managing neuropathic pain. However, research notes that these meds can carry the unwanted side effect of worsened neuropathy symptoms in some rare instances. Opioids, including tramadol and oxycodone, can be used to reduce neuropathic pain. However, this class of drug has long been known to create adverse effects if overused. Indeed, studies have shown that becoming dependent on opioids has the potential to increase neuropathic symptoms, among other serious consequences, including sleep-disordered breathing, a heightened risk of bone fractures, and even an increased risk of a dangerous overdose. So, in the end, what do these findings tell us? Any FDA-approved medication prescribed by your doctor should be used as specified by your doctor, to the letter. Your medicine regime should also be regularly monitored and potentially adjusted by your doctor. And any medication, no matter how beneficial, always carries the potential for unwanted and serious side effects, including an increase in neuropathic pain. Therefore, it is essential that you work closely with your medical specialist to decide which medications are right for you and how you should use them as safely as possible. Now, because your nervous system is so complex, many other medications may also have the ability to lead to neuropathic side effects. So please take a look in the description box below, where you'll find a comprehensive list of medications that the American Association of Electrodiagnostic Medication has found may heighten your risk of neuropathy.